And welcome, welcome, welcome to the 20th installment of Let's Get It On, to where we celebrate a milestone, the 20 subscribers special. Not 20k, no, just 20. So that awkward moment when you have the same number of episodes as you have subscribers. So anyway, we just took over Nysos from the Skurdisiai, and in the process eliminating the Skurdisiai. The only Skurdisiai that are left are in our head, in the people who are loyal to our Skurdisiai wife. So let's check out Nysos. What is Nysos all about? Well, the most important thing about Nysos is that it has shinies. It has silver and lead, which is very important for our trade. Let's check the modifiers first. Basically nothing out of the usual. And the buildings, we have a Thracian village lead, and for some reason, can you hear the barking? To convert to a barbarian village. Are we considered barbarian? How rude! How rude! Well, I guess Thracians and the Dacians are not exactly the same. And apparently, we have here an altar of Dionysus. Well, as much as we like to drink, Dionysus is not one of our gods. We don't believe in him. And actually, what we won't convert it into any other temple. Because we want to mine either silver or lead, probably a silver mine, because money is more important than religion. Yes, and I guess one of my dogs agrees. Can you hear the barking? And I guess we shouldn't tax them. Because we only get 188 tax, which is not worth it, and we will get more public order. Speaking of public order, let's check Segundum. I think we're not losing that much anymore. Yeah, we will only have a revolution in 25 turns. So I guess the Skurdisiai were the main culprit in our struggle to keep the public happy. I guess since their king is dead, the agents aren't active anymore, and also their champions ran away, so they're not doing so well. But I guess since they're not revolting soon, let's tax them. Yeah, you should pay us compensations. And actually the tax, wow, that bumps it up to 9 turns, but almost 800 monies that we get is worth it. And I guess we should put what's his name, Pieporos. Get through it, man. I can't move. Oh yeah, because it's the same turn. And I guess since we hold Nysos, we can finally again trade with our lovely friends the Udrisians. Here,
there's a good pork roasting for you.
Thank you very much. This will also help with visibility. Other interesting trade partners we don't really have, only all kind of Illyrians, but Illyria might just be our next war target, so I don't think we will. Anyway, they don't even want to trade with us. And to the north, we don't really have anyone worthy of trade. They're all treacherous and they hate us. The only one that actually want to trade with us, we don't want to trade with them. The Erevishchi and all kind of, actually just the Erevishchi. So, yep. And some cool things we got after the battle are some interesting retinues. We got a quick-limbed head. Presumably this is Ogretoric's head. And I was originally going to give it to Pieporos. But since we got a much superior retinue, a watch goose, I will give him the goose instead, because the goose helps with public order, and he will rule from Sigundum, and Sigundum is a bit hostile to us for some reason. So yeah, have fun with your goose. And I guess there's not no one that we can give the head to, because the heart is much better than the head. And King Dotos's army leveled up. I think we should go with the second level of Wolves of the North for more map movement, because it's thematically it works. And I think the campaign map movement is a limiting factor for us. And I guess yeah, we should take Plunderers, because we are on the offensive most of the time. Because we came to conquer Pannonia, and we found ourselves in Thrace. So yeah. So I guess we should recruit with the Dotos, because our army isn't replenishing. I think, well, first of all, we should get that unit of Gririan Peltas, which again we will be referring to as Tribaliae Peltas, and these units of Xenos Scum. I think we will unite and disband 71 guys. And we will get a unit of Crowboys. The difference between the Crowboys and the Xenos Scum is really marginal. Basically, the difference between they have 10 morale, they have 10 armor and 30 morale, and the Crowboys have 8 armor but 36 morale, and they have less upkeep, only 85, while these have 91. What? That's really not worth it. But for now, we will leave them until they get more casualties. Because actually, de facto, they only cost us 66 because of all of the modifiers, and the Crowboys only cost us 62. So the de facto difference is only like four monies. So yeah, they're basically the same. But now we have thematically two similar units that look different. And I guess we should do another war council to explain the situation better. We haven't done one of those in quite a while, since we had Malva and Petrodava. And since then we have grown. We're a major global local power. Yes, our main objective was and still is to make Dacia great again, to unite Dacia and Pannonia under the rightful rule of King Dotos. And sadly for both the Erevichi and the Breuchi, who are occupying those areas. With the Erevichi, we are kind of getting on pretty well. There's even rumors about a possible trade agreement, and we also know that they are at war with some Noriai tribes that are invading them. And with the Breuchi, we have no contact with them at all. They are just local Illyrians. And the third option we have is to help our brethren, the Odrysians, with their war against the Tolistobogi. The Tolistobogi are also Celts, but kind of Hellenized Celts. Celts that got lost along the migration, and now with the fall of the Scordisci, they are fairly isolated. So let the voting begin. First will vote King Dotos, the most important of the voters. He just wants to continue the plan to go at war with the Breuchi, since the Erevichi are basically pacified, at least for now. Next one that votes will be Rigozus Wormtongue, the Warden of the East. So I guess he just stands up in the great hall of the Dacian King, and then just talks about totally different ideas about the East and how we should go and teach the Katia royal lesson, and we should avenge all the Scythian raids that have been going on, and more or less everybody ignores him. Next to vote is Chieftain Pieporos. He is a populist farmer, and he actually wants to just help who he perceives as our brothers, the Odrysians. So he wants to attack the Tolistobogi. Now, I don't view him as particularly smart, because I think this is a very bad idea. Because if we actually do manage to take over this, I think it will just make for more tensions with Odrysians, because I don't think they already like the fact that we've taken the most mindful part of Dacia, because Knossos has silver and lead and those kind of mines. Next to vote is Chief Scorleone. The slave owner, he actually also votes for invading the Breucci, because he knows that the Breucci have really, really nice wood, and he would like to get his hands on their wood for trade purposes only. So that's his motivation. Next to vote would be our queen, who also votes to invade the Breucci, because she wants to secure, she rules from Segundum, and she basically wants to secure the borders, and since she is Celtic, she won't like to, she would at least want to delay a war with the Erevischi. Next to vote is the king of the Triballiae, who also votes to fight the Tolistobogi, for the selfish reason that he just wants to fight from near his homeland, to be close to home. And the last one to vote will be Arbiter Comachiza. He represents our priest class, the followers of Zalmoxis, and he actually wants to go at war with the Erevischi, because our holy site is here in Sarmisegetusa, Kogainon, the holy mountain, and he basically wants to secure a more secure border. So I think this is somewhat of a landslide. Both the queen and the king and one of the chieftain want to do the same thing. So I think that's what we are going to do. We are going to war with the Breucci. So the first thing we should do in order to implement the war council decision is put ourselves in Rigozus's shoes and take offense. Oh my god, they are ignoring me. They're going to keep expanding in the west and ignore the east. And I can't afford that, because I live here. I am the warden of the East, and I care about the East, mostly because I warden it, because I'm a sociopath and I don't really care about people. So I guess what he will do is start trading, and by trading I mean trading by force, going deep into, well, not deep actually, just in the nearby border in Katiaroi lands, and start raiding. I assume he's raiding the local Voino, who are under the protection of the Katiaroi, just to antagonize the Katiaroi. Maybe they will come and face us. If not, this is just some really nice extra coin. And look at that, look at those pesky, the steppe wolves of the Katiaroi. I guess they came to look for us and decided to camp out. So Rigozus Wormtong, the right decision would be to retreat. You know, there's no reason to attack them, but Rigozus has a point to make. He basically, first of all, he likes blood. You know, the taste of it, the look of it, you know, he is not really all there in the head, and we will roleplay that. he basically won't mind a lot of casualties on his side, because most of his army are plebs. I mean, guys with slings, these are the old Malva lines, Komatai, just Levi spearmen, and some, I guess the X-Men are capable, and his own decent unit of hoplites that he groomed, and some youths. These are the okay units, but most of his army is subpar. So he won't mind, you know, making a whole fuss of it, like, oh my god, the east is falling, I need more men to be approved for recruitment by the Dacian Council. So he will do the unexpected. I mean, the horse lords that are used to raiding and stuff really won't see this coming when Riguzus will attack their fortified camp. So this is going to be probably really, really bad for us. Heavy casualties, if not straight out loss. The enemy has only cavalry, but I guess they are fortified, so they cage themselves. So that's the only thing that will work in our favor. They'll have at least 4 towers that will shoot at us, and most of their horses are not like naked men on horse. They have their heavy armors and archers. These two, I think there are, yeah, these are some elite Katiaroi noble and troops. I guess they really came in strength to look for who is raiding our Voino vassals. And Riguzus came knocking. Now you were asking for me? Here's a spear to the face. So see you during the battle.